Welcome back to Azure AI Essentials. In this video, I'll walk you through foundational concepts to help get you started building AI-powered applications on Azure. Whether you want to leverage APIs and SDKs or create an app without writing a single line of code. Today, we're going to look at how to create an application that can detect objects in images or videos. Object detection models can be used to enable autonomous cars to detect objects around them, to help inspect machinery, to streamline inventory management, or even to track ball and player movements during a basketball game, as you can see here. While we're using object detection as our example here, most of the concepts you'll learn can also be applied to other types of AI models. You'll follow similar steps with other types of vision models, like image classification, as well as when you're adding language, speech, and decision capabilities to your applications. With Azure Cognitive Services, you can integrate pre-built AI models into your applications with just an API call, or you can build custom models with no machine learning expertise needed. With Cognitive Services, you have a choice of APIs or SDKs for your preferred programming language. And for some Cognitive Services, you have the option of a UI-based portal experience. When it comes to deployment, you have flexibility to run in the cloud, on-prem, or on the edge, with container support for many Cognitive Services. Azure Cognitive Services provide pre-built models that make it easy to embed intelligence into your apps. First, you'll need to create a computer vision resource in the Azure portal. Once you create your resource, you'll get two important pieces of information that you'll need to make API calls. Subscription keys are secret values that are used by client apps to authenticate. And the endpoint is the HTTP address at which your resource can be accessed. For our object detection application, we can use pre-built models accessed through the Computer Vision API. To call the API, you can use the client library, which is available in multiple languages. The client library can be installed using a simple script, and you can then get access to all the computer vision functionality without having to handle low-level interactions with the server yourself. A successful response will be returned in JSON format. Here, you can see that common objects were detected for this image. The output for each object is a bounding box to describe where the object is in the image, and a confidence score to show confidence level of the object being correctly identified. The pre-built computer vision models provide rich information about the image, including tags, a full sentence description, detection of any inappropriate content, and more. For many scenarios, these pre-built models will be sufficient, but often you'll want to create a custom model optimized for a particular domain and use case. For example, a retail company may want to train a model to detect specific products they carry. With Cognitive Services, you can create a custom model in minutes, and you can rely on built-in security and privacy for both your data and trained models. For our object detection application, we'll use Custom Vision, another cognitive service. Custom Vision is available as a set of SDKs, as well as through a web-based interface, which we'll use here. Either can be used to create, train, and test a custom model using your own training data. The first step is to collect images to use to train the model. Training the model with more images should increase the accuracy, and we recommend starting with at least 30 high-quality images per object and a similar number of images per object. To make sure your model isn't biased and can generalize well, it's important to get a diverse set of images, showing objects of different sizes, in different contexts, with a variety of backgrounds, lighting conditions, and camera angles. The next step is to go to the Custom Vision portal, create an object detection project, and upload your images. To prepare your training set, draw a rectangle, called a bounding box, around the object in the image, and tag it with the name of the object. Repeat until you've tagged all images. Now, you're ready to train, test, and publish your model. Creating the optimal model is an iterative process. Once you train your model, you'll get some performance metrics, which you can use to help evaluate your model. Then you can continue to refine by adjusting or adding to the training data set and retraining the model. There are two outcomes you want to avoid when training an AI model: an underfit and an overfit model. An underfit model is one that performs worse than a random guess. An overfit model performs very well, if not perfectly, when run on your training data, but it won't perform well with a different set of data. Both outcomes indicate problems with the training data. Testing your model on new images is a good best practice to help you build an accurate model. Precision and recall are two different measurements of the effectiveness of your object detector. You can also adjust the probability threshold, which is the level of confidence that a prediction needs to be considered correct. A high probability threshold tends to result in high precision with low recall. In other words, you'll get some false negatives. A low probability threshold will do the opposite and give you more false positives. You'll want to set the threshold according to the needs of your project. Once you're happy with your model, there are two ways to add your model to an application. One option is to publish your model, get a prediction endpoint, and then call that endpoint from your application. This method is often the best choice when optimizing for performance. Here we're going to use the second method and export the model, because we'll be running this model on an edge device. This is a good option when you need very low latency for your use case. If you want to deploy your model on-prem or on the edge, many cognitive services, including custom vision, support containers, so you can deploy anywhere that Kubernetes is supported. Simply select the Docker option when you're exporting your model. As you've seen, it's easy to get started adding intelligence to your applications, and Azure Cognitive Services provide many options for you to develop on your terms. Code-free or in the language of your choice, using pre-built models or customizing with your own data, and finally deploying anywhere, in the cloud, on-prem, or on the edge. Thanks for taking the time to watch, and we'll see you next time on Azure AI Essentials.